We'll see that what is integrated aquaculture and how integrated aquaculture in Asian countries, especially India, is useful for small fish farmers. Integrated aquaculture can be defined as sequential linkage between two or more agri-related farming activities with one farming as major component. Here we can see that it is the interrelationship of two or more farming activities with fish as major component. It is important nowadays because continuously the land holdings of fish farmers is decreasing day by day. So it is better to use a small area for agricultural purpose in a optimum way and in a sustainable way with greater and improved efficiency. Integrated aquaculture is being practiced in many countries since last thousands of years. The important countries practicing integrated aquaculture are China, Hungary, Germany, Poland, Russia, and in some parts of India it is being followed. The main important states that where the integrated aquaculture is being practiced are Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, West Bengal, Bihar, Kerala, and Uttar Pradesh. In northeastern state, the important state are Assam, Manipur, Tripura, and Mizoram. The importance of integrated farming system is that the waste of one system are used to increase the productivity of pond so that the fish production also increases. Since the waste are used, it decreases the input cost of a fish farmer and it also increases the output cost, because if a unit production is being obtained as low cost, automatically the margin profit of the farmers increases. This also ensure continuous food supply with less risk and output. It also offers employment to the poor. The important species in integrated fish farming in India especially are Indian major carp, that is IMC, Katla, Rohu, Mrigal, along with exotic carp, that is silver carp, grass carp and common carp. See that Katla, Rohu, Mrigal are being cultivated since last many years together in the same pond. Since Katla is a surface feeder, Rohu is a column feeder, Mrigal is a bottom feeder, with different these three fishes have different feeding habits and feeding zone. So when we stock these all three fishes along with silver carp, grass carp and common carp, these all six fishes resides in three different columns, three different layer of water. Katla and silver carp lives in the upper surface of water layer in pond, Rohu and grass carp lives in the column water, and Mrigal and common carp lives at the bottom of the pond. In this way, these fishes utilize all the food available for their own growth. So we get a increased fish production. If we stock only one fish, then it will utilize whatever the food is available in that particular layer of water. So the food available in other two layer of water still remain unutilized. This just waste the food available in other layer of water. So it is always advisable to stock at least three species of fish, four species of fish, or we can also go for five or six species culture, that is known as composite fish culture. Other species that can be integrated that can be used for integrated aquaculture are mangur, murrells and freshwater pond, that is Macrobacterium rosenbergi and Macrobacterium malcolm shorn. See, this is the composition of fresh manure from received from various animal species. Since carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, calcium and other minerals are important in increasing the pond productivity, it is very important to know their composition. Especially if in this video we'll see that how cattle cum fish integration is important for fish farming. In this video we have seen that we have already stated that the waste from one system are used as input in the other. So the manure is a waste received from cattle, sheep and pig, and this slide explains the general composition of this manure. When we put this manure into the pond, this organic manure dissolve into the water. The nutrient content in this manure are dissolved into the water and are used to increase the fish food organisms, right from algae, then zooplankton, and algae, phytoplankton and zooplankton are most important natural fish feed organisms upon which the fish depend for their growth. If we go for livestock cum fish farming system, we can go for either for cattle cum fish farming system, duck cum fish farming system, poultry cum fish farming system, goat cum fish farming system and rabbit cum fish farming system, but here we will discuss some important integrated system. In fish cum cattle farming system, for 1 hectare pond, 5 to 6 cow minimum can provide adequate manure to fertilize the 1 hectare pond. These manure, that is fresh manure, are put into the pond. It dissolve into the water and increase the availability of fish food organism. Over a year, the fish production we receive ranges between 3 to 4 ton per hectare per year. Milk production, milk we receive, that is 9,000, near about 9,000 liters per year. So in addition to fish, we are also receiving here and good amount of milk that is used to increase the income of farmer, as well as we have also seen that manure, that is waste from cattle, are used as input for increasing the fish food organisms into the in fish cum pig farming system. A full grown pig provides 500 to 600 kg of dung in a year. We have seen that 40 to 45 number of pigs are enough to fertilize 1 hectare of pond that is containing fish. Some important species breeds of pig are White Yorkshire, Land Rash and Hampshire, which can be reared on the band of the pond. The excreta, that is manure, dung and urine, are directly put into the water, or they can be stocked, they can be put into one corner of pond in a pan so that the manure, dung, urine dissolve slowly into the pond water. In fish cum goat farming, 50 to 60 goats are sufficient to fertilize 1 hectare pond. One adult goat that is weighing around 20 kg discharges 300 to 400 gram excreta on daily basis. The important breeds of goat are Beetle, Barbary and Jamunapari. This integration provides 3500 to 4000 kg of fish per hectare per year without any supplementary feeding and fertilizing the pond in addition. And this type of integrated farming system also produces 700 to 900 kg of goat meat. So the goat meat received in addition to fish production act as additional income to the fish farmer. In fish cum poultry farming systems, the chicken droppings that are rich in phosphorus and nitrogen are used to increase the productivity of the pond. The in general 5% of total body weight of poultry birds are discharged as in the form of excreta directly into the pond. For 1 hectare pond, we have seen that 500 to 600 poultry birds are enough to fertilize 1 hectare pond. And for a larger pond size, we can also go for 1000 chicks per hectare. If we have some management idea, the number of chicks to be reared in 1 hectare pond can be increased. In this system, the fish production received ranges between 3 to 4.5 ton of fish per hectare per year, and in addition to poultry birds egg, we receive 500 to 700 kg of meat that can be sold in market to increase the profit margin of fish farmer. In fish cum duck farming, ducks are known as bioaerator because they directly swims into the pond and create a wave into the pond that helps to increase the dissolved oxygen into the pond water. To fertilize 1 hectare of fish pond, total number of duck required is 2250 around. The total fish production that we got in duck fish farming system is 3.5 to 4.5 ton per hectare per year, and duck meat that we receive remains around 500 to 700 kg, that is in addition to their eggs. So duck meat and their eggs and discharge of their baits increases the fish production and income of the fish farmer. The important species of ducks are Indian runner, khaki Campbell, Perkin and white Pekin. If we are having a piece of land, then it is also necessary that how much area must be used for fish farming and how much area must be used for other animal rearing. Generally 60 to 65% of land are used for pond construction, and 25% of area can be used for other purposes, for growing crops if we are crops and fodder if we are going for cattle cum fish farming culture, and 10% of area is allowed for engineering. Liming and manuring are important steps of pond preparation because lime helps to maintain the pH of pond water. It also helps to kill the harmful bacteria, parasites and their eggs in present into the pond bottom. So generally 250 kg of lime is applied in a pond having area of 1 hectare when the soil pH is in normal range. And manure generally that is applied per year is ranges between 10,000 kg to 20,000 kg. If we are going to apply this manure in a phase-wise manuring is generally preferred, because if we are going to apply this manure phase-wise, then the pond productivity will be continuously maintained to produce the fish food organism. And when the fish food organism are present continuously, the fish growth is maintained. If we are going for duck manure, 5000 to 7500 kg of duck manure is sufficient to fertilize 1 hectare pond for 1 year. Likewise, poultry manure is more productive, therefore 500 kg to 10,000 kg of manure is sufficient to fertilize 1 hectare. The fish stocking ratio that is maintained in integrated fish farming system, if we are going for 6 species culture, that is generally preferred. Fingerlings of 6 to 10 centimeter size stocking is preferred. The stocking density maintained ranges between 10,000 to 12,000 numbers per hectare. The IMC, that is Rohu, Mrigal Katla, exotic carp, silver carp, grass carp and common carps are the six main species preferably used for stocking in integrated fish farming systems. If we are going for three species culture, the stocking ratio among IMC maintained is 40:30:30. So if we are going for 1000 fish stocking according to our area, remains around 400 katla, that is surface feeder, 300 rohu column feeder and 300 nan bottom feeder. Likewise, if we are going for six species culture, surface feeder can be splitted into two, that is katla 30%, silver carp 10%, column feeder rohu 25%, grass carp 5% and bottom feeder mrigal 15% and common carp 15%. So we have seen that integrated aquaculture helps to optimize our resource utilization by reducing the cost of input and diversification of crop production. It also helps to reduce the risk of crop production. We have generally seen that the farmers who are going for one crop cultivation, when there is any natural calamity or disease occurrence, the whole crop is lost. But when we are going for integrated aquaculture farming system, there is chance that both the crops grows perfectly, or either if there is a disease problem in fish or poultry, other can survive. So risk is also minimized in integrated aquaculture farming system. Thank you.